Let's multiply by 2, all the way up to 10. We'll multiply by 2, then we'll do it again. When we multiply by 2, you'll use a times table. It's a fun, easy way to learn because you're able. Let's count by 2s and we'll make it rhyme. Then you'll find multiplication is a good time. 2, 4, 6, 8. We just multiplied 1 through 4, I hope you feel great. 10, 12, 14, 16 are the next batch of numbers that we sing. 18 and 20 is where we will end when we're multiplying by 2 up to 10. Anytime you do multiply any number by 2, you just double that number and the equation is through. For example, 2 times 1 does equal 2, and 2 times 2 equals 4, this is true. 2 times 3 does equal 6, and 2 times 4 equals 8 in this mix. 2 times 5 will always equal 10, and 2 times 6 equals 12 here and then. 2 times 7 does equal 14, and 2 times 8 equals 16 on the scene. 2 times 9 equals 18, and 2 times 10 equals 20 again. Now sing with me. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, you're doing great. 14, 16, 18, 20, when multiplying by 1 through 10, this is plenty. 2 times 1 does equal 2, and 2 times 2 equals 4, this is true. 2 times 3 does equal 6, and 2 times 4 equals 8 in this mix. 2 times 5 will always equal 10, and 2 times 6 equals 12 here and then. 2 times 7 does equal 14, and 2 times 8 equals 16 on the scene. 2 times 9 equals 18, and 2 times 10 equals 20 again. Let's multiply by 2, all the way up to 10. We'll multiply by 2, then we'll do it again. When we multiply by 2, you'll use a times table. It's a fun, easy way to learn because you're able.
I am the multiplication table. Remember me because you're able. We'll learn to multiply 1 through 10, up to 100 because you can.
Let's start by learning how the times table works, because learning to multiply is one of life's perks. You see that vertical line, it's numbered 1 through 10, and the horizontal line is numbered the same again. All the numbers on the inside we will cover next. They're the answers to the equations you will see in text. For example, if you look at the number 2 and you want to multiply it by 7, here's what you'll do. Let's use this 2 from the vertical side and multiply it with the 7 on the horizontal guide. Run a line from the 2, if you know what I mean, and a line from the 7 down to see where they meet. Where the 2 lines collide will be the answer you seek. 2 times 7 equals 14, this equation is complete. You can also use the horizontal number 2 and the vertical 7 to achieve the same results, it's true. Now let's try to multiply 5 times 5, where the 2 lines meet. Answer is 25. Another example is multiplying 9 times 6. The 2 lines meet at 54, where your eyes are transfixed. Here's one more equation, it's 8 times 4. The answer is 32. After this chorus, there is more.
I am the
times 2 and it does equal 4. 3 times 3 equals 9 and 4 times 4 is 16. 5 times 5 is 25, now you know what I mean. 6 times 6 is 36 and 7 times 7 is 49. 8 times 8 is 64, now I know you're feeling fine. 9 times 9 equals 81, yeah that is what I said. And 10 times 10 equals 100, you can see here in red. You can move across or down and multiply each number on its own. Let's try a couple out, then you can continue at home. Multiplying by 1, yeah, it is so easy. You always end up with the same number you multiply by, you see. 1 times 1 equals 1, and 2 times 1 is 2. And 3 times 1 equals 3, now you practice to move to 2 and count straight across. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, start over if you're lost. Row 14, 16, 18, and 20. Let's try one more row, start at the number 3. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, and 18. 21, 24, 27, and 30. Download your times table sheet from KLT site and practice multiplying till you get it right.
I am the multiplication table. Remember me because you're able. We'll learn to multiply 1 through 10. Up to 100 because you can. When you multiply any number by 1, it always equals the same number as when you begun. When you multiply any number by 1, it always equals the same number. Let's work an equation.
This multiplication table will help see us through. When we multiply 1 by all the numbers up to 10, it is true. This time symbol will separate each number multiplied. The equal symbol will give us the total on its right side. When you take a 1 and multiply it by a 1, it equals 1, the same number as it had begun. 1 times 2 equals the number 2. And 1 times 3 equals 3, you see. 1 times 4 equals the number 4. And 1 times 5 equals 5 here live. And 1 times 6 equals the number 6. 1 times 7 equals itself 7. 1 times 8 equals 8, 'cause it's great. And 1 times 9 equals 9, it's so fine. 1 times 10 does equal 10. And here we go, let's multiply 1 again. When you take a 1 and multiply it by a 1, it equals 1, the same number as it had begun. 1 times 2 equals the number 2. And 1 times 3 equals 3, you see. 1 times 4 equals the number 4. And 1 times 5 equals 5 here live. And 1 times 6 equals the number 6. 1 times 7 equals itself 7. 1 times 8 equals 8, 'cause it's great. And 1 times 9 equals 9, it's so fine. 1 times 10 does equal 10. And here we go, let's multiply 1 again.
When you multiply any number by 1, it always equals the same number as when you begun. When you multiply any number by 1, it always equals the same number. Let's work an equation. When you multiply any number by 1, it always equals the same number as when you begun. When you multiply any number by 1, it always equals the same number. Let's work an equation.
Let's multiply 1 through 10. We'll be smarter by the end, and then we can start over again. Let's multiply 1 through 10. Math is so easy when you focus. Let's understand how numbers blend. Let's start by counting by 1. Here we go. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Sometime we'll do that again. Now let's move on and count by two. Here we go. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. You're doing well. 14, 16, 18, 20. That's plenty. This is what you see when counting by three. Here we go. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. You're counting up on the screen. 18, 21, 24, 27, and 30. Multiplication is a dream. Now we'll be counting by four. Go! 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, and 40 makes 10. That's plenty. One of my favorites is counting by 5. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. Great work, you are busy. Up in the mix, now we're counting by 6. 6, 12, 18, 24, and 30. When you're counting by 6, sing along with me. 36, 42, 48, 54, and 60. When multiplying through 10, that's all you'll see. We're here, good heavens, let's count by 7. 7, 14, 21, 28, and 35. You're doing great, let's keep this live. 42, 49, 56, 63, and 70. You're beginning to thrive. This is great, we're counting by 8. 8, 16, 24, 32, and 40, 48, 56, 64, 72, and 80. You're doing fine when counting by 9. 9, 18, 27, 36, 45, 54, 63, in the mix, 72, 81, and 90. We're not through. Now 9 is behind me. We are at the end because we're counting by 10. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. The multiplication table is what you completed. Let's multiply 1 through 10. We'll be smarter by the end, and then we can start over again. Let's multiply 1 through 10. Math is so easy when you focus. Let's understand how numbers blend. Let's make a decision to learn about division. We'll split numbers into equal groups or parts equally. Now try to envision the importance of division. We'll count how many times one value's contained in another. It is key. Welcome to your division lesson. I'm a division sign, you know. A short horizontal line with a dot above and another dot below. You can find me between two numbers that will attempt to divide. But before we start an equation, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine. I'm the equal sign made up of two parallel horizontal lines. I indicate equality of two expressions on each side of my sign. Together we find how many times one value is contained in another, you'll see. Let's look at our first equation. Division's amazing, you'll agree. Let's take this 15 and divide it by 3. How many times can the 3 go into 15? Let's find out and see. Let's make 3 circles that represent the 3 and add a single dot in each until we reach the number 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, there is more. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, you're doing well. Now that we have reached the total number of 15 dots, you can count the dots in one circle to get the answer we have sought. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 is the amount of times 3 can go into 15 after we divide. The number of dots in one circle when we split 15 into 3. 5 is the amount of times 3 goes into 15 equally. You're doing great, let's move on sensation. Let's take this 14 and divide it by 2. Let's see how many times 2 fits into 14, and then we will be through. Let's make 2 circles that will represent the 2. Then add a single dot in each until we reach the number 14 true. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you're doing great. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, your counting is really swell. Now that we've counted 14 dots within the 2 circles we drew, let's count how many dots are in one circle to see how many we accrued. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 7 is the answer that we're looking for in this equation. This tells me 2 goes into 14 7 times. This is how you do basic division. Now pick 2 numbers and divide. Watch this division video over again until you can divide any number, then go show your friends. Let's make a decision to learn about division. We'll split numbers into equal groups or parts equally. Now try to envision the importance of division. We'll count how many times one value's contained in another. It is key. I am addition. This is my mission. You're here to add some knowledge you need to succeed and thrive. It's addition, and this is how it's spelled. This is the process of adding something to something else. I am an addition symbol, which you'll use to add. I'm kinda shaped like a cross, and that's pretty rad. You can add anything to another thing with me. Just take 2 objects, put me in the middle, and see. But before we get started, there's someone you have to meet. It's my friend, the equal symbol. He's a math athlete. I am the equal symbol. You'll find me to the right of any math equation. I bring the final amount in sight. I work with any math symbol to get the answer you need. Let us show you how we help each other to succeed. I am addition, and this is my mission. You're here to add some knowledge you need to succeed and thrive. It's addition, and this is how it's spelled. This is the process of adding something to something else. We'll start adding something simple to see what we can equal. This is one panther, but if you want to, you'll add one more as well. Then I take the panthers, which now equal 2. That's the number I produce now that this equation is through. Here are 2 babies, and when I add 2 more, I equal the total number of babies, which is 4. I am addition, and this is my mission. You're here to add some knowledge you need to succeed and thrive. It's addition, and this is how it's spelled. This is the process of adding something to something else. And if you add 5 ice creams and you add 5 more, it will equal 10 ice creams. That's twice as many as before. And here I have 3 elephants, and when I add 1 other, I equal them together, which is 4, I assure. You can add anything you want to anything else when you have an addition and equal symbol to help. When you have the number 5 and you also want to add 2, the final number equals 7. This equation is through. And if you had a 3 and wanted to add 3 more, you would end up equaling the number 6 out the door. I am addition, and this is my mission. You're here to add some knowledge you need to succeed and thrive. It's addition, and this is how it's spelled. This is the process of adding something to something else. I'm addition, and this is my mission. You're here to add some knowledge you need to succeed and thrive. It's addition, and this is how it's spelled. This is the process of adding something to something else. I am subtraction, and this is my action. I take a number or an amount away from another with satisfaction. I'm subtraction, and I'll show you what I do. When you have a whole number, I decrease that number's size. It's true. I'm a subtraction and symbol, and this is how I look. A short horizontal line, you'll find me in any subtraction book. My job's to take away a particular quantity from an amount of anything in a math equation based on me. I'm opposite of the addition symbol, which is used to add. So when you add too much of something, just subtract, you'll feel glad. But before we move on to a subtraction equation, the equal symbol's introduction will complete our calculation. Hi, I'm the equal symbol, it's nice to meet you. Up to the right of a math equation, and this is what I do. I take the value of an equation from the right of me and show it's equal in value or amount. To my left, you see, I am subtraction, and this is my action. I take a number or an amount away from another with satisfaction. I'm subtraction, and I'll show you what I do. When you have a whole number, I decrease that number size, it's true. Here we will go through some examples of what I do. I will team up with the equal symbol so we can show you. Here we have 5 T-Rexes, as you can plainly see. But if you subtract 2, the final amount equals 3. But if you have 6 macaws, but you only want 2, you would subtract 4 from 6 to equal 2. This equation's through. Now if you have 3 gorillas, but 2 is all you need, you would subtract 1 from 3 to equal 2. Now let's proceed. Here's 2 orangutan, but 1 is what you'd like. Just subtract 1 from 2, which equals 1 orangutan in sight. I am subtraction, and this is my action. I take a number or an amount away from another with satisfaction. I'm subtraction, and I'll show you what I do. When you have a whole number, I decrease that number size, it's true. You can subtract anything with the subtraction and equal symbol. Here's some examples with numbers, we'll try to keep it real simple. So if you have the number 10 but want half of that, you would subtract 5 from 10 to equal 5, that's a fact. And when you have an 8 and subtract 3 from it, it equals the number 5. I hope you're understanding this. But when you have 11 and you take away 5, the number that it equals is 6. Remember this and thrive. Now go take this lesson that you had just learned, and subtract any amount from something else without concern. I am subtraction, and this is my action. I take a number or an amount away from another with satisfaction. I'm subtraction, and I'll show you what I do. When you have a whole number, I decrease that number size, it's true. I am subtraction, and this is my action.